What's going on, survivors? Welcome back to day 24 here, coming up at you, and it's time to get to work on this base. Now, I went and mined some stone. I'll show you here in a minute what I did. Oh, I gotta clear all this out. I had a wandering horde come at me overnight. Just get some goodies going here. No, wait, I want that. There we go. And that and that. Make more. I'll take what you got. Put those. Okay. Let me run back into the house here. And then I'll show you what I did here. But I'll tell you right now, I took out one more level. And I'm still kind of thinking of going down one more. You know, the bigger the drop, the better, you know? But I'm also thinking of another way of hurting these guys when they come down into the pits. And when I get done offloading all this stuff, I will show you what I mean. I haven't set it up yet, so I will be taking you guys along the ride here with me. Where was it? There it is. Aloe vera. Oh, let me get some more of them all out. Just use these up here real quick. I used up the points that I had. Alright, we're good to go. We're good to go. Nope, turn that off. Get a quick bite to eat. Using those cans can be tricky. Can be, you know, it's a gamble. Those unlabeled cans, but I really haven't had an issue with them. So it would seem that as long as you are not eating them, you know, like it's Pez, like it's candy, then you should be fine. It does have a slight risk of food poisoning, though. So it's something you should keep in mind. Unfortunately, there's no recipes for them, so since it is an unlabeled can, you don't know what you're really getting. I got company down there. Hi, friend. Why are you not loaded? I've been so used to playing Player Unknown Battlegrounds, I keep on hitting F to access things. It's E, not F. Okay, so anyway, I went and did one more layer down here, and I'm thinking about doing one or two more layers, and I don't think it's something I'm going to do on camera. If I do, I'll end up just fast-forwarding it. Spare you guys having to watch all that. But here's what I'm thinking of doing. Now, normally, I would just dig out this dirt here and put the wall down on the inside. Now, the thing I'm thinking is to probably start here and just stepping down like this. And so say that's going to be the base. So what I'm looking at is having these guys drop down each level onto a bed of spikes. Now, if they happen to die up there, then, let's see, can I take this out? Yes, I can. What I plan on doing is having a post. It's probably how I should have done like that. So I have a post like this. That one's going to be a post, and then that one up there is going to be a post, and I will have different levels for me to kind of just catwalks, basically. And so I can come along, I can do repairs, I can loot the bodies, you know, I can do all that stuff. So that is the kind of idea I'm looking at here as for the whole step down process. Now, if I go with that, though, let's see, where was I? Well, let me do this. Let me... Oh, come on. Let me reach it. Okay, fine. Fine. I'll get up here. Okay, so... Probably have that one there. Or is it like this? Like that. Yeah. Beautiful. That actually works out. Well, no, not... Oh, well, I see what I did. Okay. There we go. Now that works out. So they're going to drop down, walk, drop down, and here's going to be the ground. So that'll work. That'll work. I mean, that one's got two, but you guys get the idea. So if I'm doing that... And we were 20 across here. So now I got to do math. So let's see. There's the wall. So let's just say this is the wall. So we are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 out. And I'll use these. Nope. All right, gotta pick up my mess. Come on, I hate it when it just jumps like that. Okay, so that's what I'm looking for as far as my inner wall. And that would leave... Let me use these to kind of pretend to be spikes. Those to be spikes. Does that make sense? Yeah, that's two. Okay. Okay. I think this is gonna work. Yeah. Yeah, I think that is going to work. Yes, maybe. That makes two rows of spikes, so actually I can move this in one. You up there. Oh, boogers. Alright, let's try this. So, alright, we go there, then we go down. There we go. So it winds up the same, opening, opening, opening. What do you guys think? Is that the step down idea? Is that something that's worth it, or? I'm just gonna go ahead and drop all this down here right now for the base. I mean, it does take out the fall damage. It's not, I mean, when I was mining this out, one did, and that might be him, actually. One did fall down, and he did scream. You know, he did do his little whatever sound from falling that distance. So I do know it will hurt them. How much, I don't know. Is this gonna work? Yes. Is this gonna work? Yes. All right. I like it. I like it. Works for me. So from here on out now, it basically becomes a style thing. You know, do I want to put concrete all in through here? Or maybe I want to make brick. I'm going to use concrete for the outer walls, though. Because if I'm down here shooting at these guys and I miss them, I don't want to have to go around replacing or repairing brick or wood or something like that. So I will probably end up using concrete on the inside walls, as well as the step downs and whatnot. And as far as what kind of concrete, though, let's see here. Not cop. Nope. If I could spell. There we go. We got different types of concrete here. You got a regular concrete block. You got concrete brick block. That doesn't look too bad with the bricks. It might be kind of hard for you guys to see, but it looks like it's bricks, but concrete, obviously. What else do we have here? Trim. Okay, the concrete trim 2-block is just basically two half slabs put on top of each other. So that doesn't look too bad. Auto wall concrete. When placed on the ground, these walls will automatically grow up to a stack of 5 blocks high. Hmm. And then there's one for reinforced, and then there's the hidden door concrete. Interesting. So let's see, what does it take here for the... Okay, concrete mix is 10, so it is a little expensive. 10 concrete for each one, but then again, it's already 10 concrete just to form. It's actually 20 if I'm using the rebar here, because I'm gonna have to... No, it's just 10. Yeah. Yeah, what am I thinking? No, I don't want to use a bone. I want to use the hammer. Oh, I don't have wood. I thought I did. Alright, well, guess what? Scrap all that. Yeah, that'll work. I have myself a plan. Alright, now I got wood. Yep, just 10. See down there in the lower right? Just 10, so. Let me get... It's going to be a tough one here. The bricks. Yeah, I'm going to go with the trim. I'm going to go with the trim. Give me that. Oh, it's going to take a little bit. Oh, no, I already have them. I've got them. Oh, crap. There's that freaking... No, I'm going to go ahead and place it down for you without even really... All right, now here is... Let's see. Yeah, I'm going to have to break this one out. 3,000 hit points. Now, can these... All right, I know they can be repaired, but can they be upgraded? Yes, they can. So one smack will upgrade them to reinforced. So if you guys... That is also a very nice little handy tip for everyone to remember is if you do put down concrete brick or block, you know, the preformed concrete blocks, or even this, for example, I imagine it will work if you use concrete brick as well. But if you guys go and put that stuff down and, oh, you know, like it's right here, I put it in the wrong freaking spot, then all you have to do is just upgrade it to the reinforced. Yeah, it does cost you 10. And then you can go ahead and break it away. And as you saw, it was only 1,500 hit points. Now, taking away. There we go. I'm going to put you there and put you there. There we go. All right. Oh, that's a cobblestone pillar. Oh, okay, okay. Well, yeah, what the hell am I thinking? That's not, okay. Okay. Man, that's my screw up. Oh, boogers. I was worried about that happening. Well, concrete pillar it is. Make another one of these. Actually, I need another one for the one up there. Get up there. Oh, of course I can't see that. All right. Excellent. Then I can just come along here. Boop, boop, boop. Shoot them. Shoot them if I want. Or I can go ahead and just clean. I can repair. I can do it all. And this leaves me with a nice little work area here. I'm not going to be able to do the spiral staircase, I think. I'll probably end up having to do a ladder straight up. I was kind of hoping to do a spiral staircase up, kind of make it look nice, you know, but I think for this instance, yeah, this is the way it's going to have to be, is I work my way up and that's that. Alright, so let me make up 20 of these. Not a fun part, digging out all this dirt, but it'll also give me a chance to just talk to you guys and apologize for not doing these as often as I would like. If you guys watch any of my ATS videos, you know that there's been a new game out that's in alpha stages right now. It's an early game. But there's a new game out that the crew and myself have been playing religiously. We really haven't been able to stop. And unfortunately, it's, you know, jacked with my recording schedule for videos for you guys. You know, so it's unfortunate, you know. I've been trying to break myself of that. You know, I'm at work and, okay, I'm going to go home and I'm going to do 7 days. I'm going to go home and do ATS. I'm going to go home and get iRacing done and, you know, this and that, whatever. And, you know, it doesn't always work out that way. But I've been slacking on doing these videos and, you know, the last time anyone saw anything with me in 7 days to die was the live stream I did a week ago. So, you know, it not good. Not good at all. But I'm, bottom line, you know, for many of us, you know, I'm a gamer at heart. You know, so I'll end up playing a game first and recording second. You know, because, you know, YouTube is not my full-time job. It's nowhere near my full-time job. I wouldn't even call it a part-time job. So, oh, I hate it. That's another thing I don't like is when those hit points on these blocks are off. I just took a chunk out of the inside wall. I'm probably going to want to do that anyway when I start digging the catwalks out, but still, it's not something I'm really looking to do right now. But anyway, you know, I'm a gamer first and YouTuber second. So, well, actually, YouTuber's probably like further down the line when you consider, you know, I have a normal job like everyone else and I'm married and I'm a father and... But, you know, fortunately, I do have the luxuries that many others don't to do all of this. And, you know, so far, not have it, knock on wood, have it affect my personal life. So, like, not, the same cannot be said for everyone. But, you know, as I tell everyone that I know, you know, family first, man. You know, I've had people, oh, sorry, Casket, I can't make it to this, or, you know, sorry I'm late, and, you know, whatever. And it's like, dude, no, family first, man. Gaming and everything else comes second, you know. When I was RC racing, one of the forums that I would visit constantly had people in there, you know, oh, I'm not going to make this race, you know, whatever race it is, because, well, you know, I've got to try to save my marriage or save my relationship and things like that. And, you know, it's unfortunate. And, you know, sometimes people that we are with, you know, they might not share the same love for something that we do. You know, whatever it might be. It could be playing World of Warcraft until the wee hours in the morning. Or it can be, you know, playing video games. Or, you know, hell, like, I don't care if it's like knitting or even chess. You know, you guys get the point. So, you know, family first, life first. You know, everything else is second. And if you've got people around you that, you know, your friends or, you know, people you play with or whatever that can't or won't understand that or refuse that, well, it's time to find some new friends. You know, I have not, as of late, met anyone that, you know, basically, you know, was like, screw that, no, you gotta do this, or screw that, no, you gotta do that, or whatever. And it's, no, family first, take care of your own. But, wow, I really went off on a rant or tangent or whatever. I really rambled on that one, didn't I? But, no, the reason why I have not been putting out 7 days episodes is not because of any of that. It's just because I just been playing other stuff. And next thing I know, it's, you know, 10:30, and I don't have time to do something else. So I hope to change that. You know, I did stream the 21-day horde and a couple other days over on Twitch. And so for those who do not know, I will be streaming on Twitch way more often than I do on YouTube. And this game is actually one of the games I do plan on streaming occasionally over on Twitch. So be sure, guys, if you are signed up on Twitch, that you go over there and you follow me over there, CasketMan20. So it's twitch.tv/CasketMan20. And make sure you have your alerts set to on, because that way you will get an email alert or a phone. Oh, excuse me. An email alert or a text alert letting you know that I am streaming. As of right now, I'm planning on streaming American Truck Simulator and 7 Days to Die. Really no particular order. It's just going to be kind of a variety thing. I know some have told me, you know, hey, you need to pick a main game. You know, you need to pick what game you're going to play and, you know, use that as your main one. If you're going to stream 3 times a week, at least twice a week, you know, preferably 3 times, every time you stream for those 3 times needs to be, you know, such and such game. You know, I kind of don't like being roped into just one game. You know, I got that way here on this channel with American Truck Simulator, and I'm trying to break out of that cycle where I only have one game. And, you know, it's gotten some resistance from some fans. You know, they, you know, teach their own. You know, there are plenty of people out there who think 7 Days to Die is the best game out there, and that is all they're going to play. The same goes for other games, you know, American Truck Simulator, Euro Truck Simulator, whatever. You know, everyone has their own preference on what they like and what they want to play, and, you know, that's fine. That's fine, and not a problem. But, you know, for me and the channel here, I want to make sure I expand, and, you know, same goes for Twitch. I want to make sure, you know, I'm not locked into just one type of game. It does slow down on the rates I gain followers or subscribers. But, you know, is what it is. What the hell just broke? Oh. Oh, because I'm taking this out. Okay. Since I'm taking away the dirt, those are going to fall. I gotcha. So I have to put up a new one. Where can I get out here? Missed one. Ah, there it is. There we go. Now I can get out. Yes. Yay. Awesome. Alright, back to work. Shovel needs to get replaced as well. I'll do that tonight, overnight here. But yeah. I'll be streaming at least one day a week, hopefully over here with 7 Days to Die on Twitch. So, like I said, check the link for description, but it's casketman.tv, or I'm sorry, twitch.tv/casketman. So I'll be doing a variety of games over there, American Truck Sim, Farm Sim, 7 Days, you know, just, you know, whatever I do feel like doing or whatever the crew feels like doing. So hopefully you guys follow me over there and you end up, you know, enjoying what I put out there for you guys. And don't forget, you know, CasketMan20 on Facebook, CasketMan20 on Twitter. Check those out. And also, if you guys wouldn't mind seeing more of this, you know, let me know. Tell me. That's really what helps out a lot. You know, the likes for videos and the comments and things like that. So, you know, I already plan on doing a long live stream when it comes to Alpha 16 coming out. That is looking like it's going to be maybe a month. There's no time frame on it, so don't quote me. But I know he... oh, now his name's drawing a blank for me. My apologies. But I know they're working on it diligently, and... Oh, see, it's going to drive me nuts because I can't remember his damn name. Madmole, there it is. Joel. You know, I know he's working hard on this new update, and there's a lot of new stuff that's going into it. So, I mean, more than I can list, to be quite honest. We're talking sleeper zombies. We're talking wolves. We're talking snakes. He posted on a forum, on the 7 Days forum, I believe it was, and someone shared it, and... he said he started a game because he wanted to see how it all is going to work. So he started a game, and he started out in a forest biome, I believe it was, and started getting chased by wolves. So he fought them off and ran away, went in the desert, lost the wolves, but then had a snake jump his ass and try to go after him. So he had to turn around and hightail it somewhere else. He went into a different biome, found a house, just to have a sleeper zombie wake up on him and start chasing him. So he fought him off, got back into the house, and then was going to go loot a body. And it turns out that was another sleeper. So he ran out of the house just to get killed by a pack of wolves. So I see a lot of rage quitting coming up here. I see a lot of that happening. I'm really looking forward to it. I really am. With the new buildings and the new way blocks are being placed and things like that, you know, it's going to be way different than what we're used to. You know, new zombies, feral zombies for even the basic zombies. You know, that's going to be something different. Wolves and two types of bears and... You know, the animal life alone is, it, you know, that's going to be fun. The new way towns spawn and how they're all going to be different, and certain buildings are only going to spawn in certain areas. And, you know, it's going to provide a whole new gaming experience. Oh, it finally broke. My shovel finally broke. Okay. It's going to provide a whole new experience for those of us who really enjoy playing 7 Days to Die. So I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully you guys are looking forward to it as well. It's going to be fun. And I'll tell you right now, and I'll remind you guys as we go on, my plan right now for 7 Days to Die when Alpha 16 is released... When Alpha 16 is released to the public, that following weekend, or possibly the weekend after that, I plan on streaming the first 8 days. I'll just call it the 8 days, because I'll go through the 7 day horde. So I'm going to do a live stream that whole day of the first 8 days on Twitch for everyone to go ahead and follow along and play or whatever. I'll put up the seed for the map and all that stuff, so everyone can go ahead and play along if they want. And I'll get through the first 7 or 8 days, whichever, and then probably end up shutting it down from there. But hopefully you guys tune in with that one, you follow along with it, and hopefully you guys enjoy. I mean, I'm really looking forward to Alpha 16. I'm looking forward to doing more live streams with 7 Days to Die. For the first time doing it over on Twitch with little or no notice, I mean, the numbers weren't all that bad, so it was better than I expected. And the views over here were right on par with what they have been. So hopefully a lot of you guys, like I said, follow me over on Facebook and on Twitter. Jump over to Twitch and follow me there and make sure you turn on your alerts so you don't miss anything. And, have some fun here in the coming, hopefully, weeks. Hopefully. A lot of stuff going on for me. A lot of stuff. Also, what else is going on for me? I will provide a link in the description for this one as well. I opened up a Patreon page. I know that's not everyone's cup of tea. Basically, asking for subscriptions from people. I do have different levels, and a lot of it is geared more towards the ATS, the American Truck Style, or American Truck Simulator. There are a couple of options, though, that even 7 Days to Die and iRacing fans can still, back me on, support me on. The way to look at it is, if you use any kind of ad blocker, then basically, you're not allowing me to earn any revenue off of any of the videos. Now, it's granted, I normally don't try to load them up with commercials in the first place. I think 3 or 4 is what I usually go with. I think it's normally 3. So I usually don't try to load them up with commercials in the first place. But the, I'm just going to do a flat 40. Well, what does a shovel take? Oh, needs 20, okay. So I try not to load them up with commercials in the first place, but if you guys, for example, have an ad blocker, you're blocking YouTube from showing off those ads, which means I'm not getting any revenue for it. So it makes it a little more difficult for me to continue to run a server and things like that, because I'm pulling money out of my own pocket. Boo-hoo, yeah, I know. But still, a lot of these things add up. Internet costs, software costs for rendering, recording, what have you, audio stuff, things like that. PC costs for, upgrades or replacing old parts and things like that. There's always something going on. And so, stuff like that, I figured, okay, I'm going to go ahead and, start this up. One of the first options is a $1 option. So for just $1 a month, you guys are able to go ahead and support me, basically making up for any ad blocking software that you have used, blocking YouTube from collecting that money from you watching that ad. The other positive thing with that is YouTube doesn't get their hands on it. That dollar goes to me. Well, then again, actually Patreon takes a small percentage of it, but still. It's better than what YouTube gives me. I'll tell you that much. The next one that would probably be suitable for you guys is the $5 one. It shows that, okay, I support you and I'll sponsor you, whatever. And so that option there, I will put your name, as long as it's proper, your name in my videos here, on every video, as well as on the website when that launches here, and then hopefully in the next month. And that will show that you guys are supporting me, you're liking what I do, you're looking for more, you know, expanding, continuing what I do, so on and so forth. So, you know, $5 a month gets you guys an official sponsorship of Casket Man 20 and the crew. It's basically saying keep up the good work. The other, let's see, $10 a month gets you access to the private Discord here on our Discord channel. Now, I do have a free Discord for everyone to go ahead and join and chat. The crew and I don't normally go over there too much because we're doing our own thing in our private Discord. So with this, what this does is it allows you guys to join our Discord as long as you continue to pay to $10 a month. Once that is canceled, you will lose the privilege of being in there. But $10 a month gets you access, not only the sponsorship part, but also access to our Discord. And so with that, like I said, you can get in there, you can talk to us if, you know, we're able to talk, if we're not busy doing something else, things like that. You know, there are crew member only rooms for my crew and I to go to and, you know, discuss, plan, whatever. But yeah, it gives you guys access to what's going on back there. Which, you know, maybe not for you guys is not a big deal, but for a lot of my ATS fans, yeah, I think they'll probably like that. Now, one option, though, that I'm sure you guys might be interested in, it's a $20 option. And what the $20 option does, it grants you guys not only all the same privileges. Oh, he's beating on the fence. Oh, screw him. Not only the same privileges from the prior ranks, the 10 and then the 5, but it grants you guys ability to join the servers that we have. Right now, I still do have a 7 Days to Die server, and it will be reset when Alpha 16 comes out. So for $20 a month, you are able to be on our Discord, you are able to join the 7 Days to Die server, and as long as you play respectfully, you were able to stay. I do reserve the right to go ahead and give someone the boot if they're being an ass clown. The same goes for Farm Sim. If you guys like Farm Sim, that will give you guys the opportunity to play Farm Sim with us when that server opens up. Hopefully next month, because I'm waiting on Pleasant Valley 17 to be finished. And right now he's kind of hoping ballpark May 1st. So once that is done, that server is going up. The crew and I will be on there playing very often, hopefully. So that will allow anyone, hey, I want to go play with Casket and his crew. I'm going to, you know, fork over $20 a month and go ahead and do that. It might be a little pricey, but like I said, you know, servers are not always cheap. So costs vary. And then if I have to increase the player slots to accommodate more people, that also increases the payment. So this right here, you know, say it's $10 a month for 6 slots, but now I'm going to add 3 more people, these 3 over here. Well, that $10 a month just shot to $15 or $13, whatever. It depends on what they charge. So the more slots I open up, the more it's going to cost me money. So yeah, it's an option, like I said. So $30 a month gets you an official crew member ranking. So you're in the Discord with us, you're in the servers, you get to be a part of the whole crew. Discord, your role on Discord is going to be crew member instead of just Patreon member. So you get to be one of the guys, Ross, Comfy Sauce, Mobius, so on. You get to be one of us. So that's $30 a month. One person's already signed up for that one. So I've limited the $20 and $30 options for just 20 people, because I can't really have I'm at 8,500 subscribers right now. I can't really have even if half of them go for it, you know, that's not going to work. I mean, so I did have to put a limit on those. I don't really expect all that stuff to sell out. I really don't. And this is just something I put out there because I have been asked multiple times, hey, how can we support you? I don't have any donation tabs or anything like that set up just yet. I will in the future. But, you know, this is one way someone can go ahead and support me and the crew, because that's the goals for $50 once I reach that every month. $50 is going to be split up between modders, my crew members for DLC and games, and also giving back to you guys, the fans who watch these videos, as giveaways for DLC and games. So at least $50 a month, that's going back to you guys. It's coming into my pocket and going right back out. So I really look forward to that. I don't really get to donate to the community, to you guys, to the crew as much as I want. I wanted to do something for Christmas with the crew, and I wasn't able to do that. So hopefully I'm able to reach that goal here, and I'm able to start giving back to the community, giving back to my fans, giving back to the crew, because honestly, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now if it wasn't for my crew. I really wouldn't. Obviously, you guys are number one. That I wouldn't be where I'm at without, you know, people following me and watching me and everything. But I think for a lot of what I do, without the crew, I wouldn't be where I'm at right now. So I'm deeply appreciative of them, just as I'm deeply appreciative of you guys, the fans. Come on, Shovel, finish. I'm just rambling on here, and it's probably caused you guys to stop watching already. But if you are still watching, thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for support. And like I said, go ahead and check out that Patreon. That's link will be in the description. Check out Twitch. Link will be in the description. Facebook, Twitter, links will be down there as well. That is going to be it for now. I'm already late as it is. So thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you on day 25. Take it easy.